a lifelong interest in science, the highly credentialed and much-travelled academic, Dr Paulo De Souza, is now part of the growing scientific community in Hobart, Tasmania.
I became interested in science since I was a kid, and I was fascinated about nature and how the world works, and the way the planet works and how everything is interconnected. It's full of mysteries, it's full of interesting things to be discovered, and I was always fascinated about discovering things and learning about the world itself. So this is where I became really interested, from anything from stars, planets, to how insects work. And it came from my childhood. I studied in Brazil, I did my PhD in Germany, I worked in France, I worked in the US, and none of these places, with due respect, can be Tasmania. It is a great place to live. I have been really well received in Tasmania. My family is happy here. It's a great place to raise your kids. The quality of life we have in Tasmania is just something you can't find anywhere else. It's safe, it's clean, it's friendly, and it's beautiful.
A physicist by training, Paulo is in very good company in Hobart. Tasmania's capital has the highest number of scientists per capita of any city in Australia, hosting 65% of all Australia's Antarctic and Southern Oceans research scientists, and many more dedicated to other disciplines. It is no accident that the University of Tasmania is ranked among the nation's best for applied research. Paulo's diverse scientific interest often involves global collaboration. In the case of honeybees, essential for the pollination of about one-third of the food we eat, food production as we know it is under serious threat. Paulo and his team of researchers are collaborating globally to seek a solution.
Bees are going through a very difficult time elsewhere in the world. In Tasmania, we still have, because we have a pristine environment and we are free from some of the most terrible pests we would see, like the varroa mite or varroa destructa. We don't have here, so our bees are relatively healthy compared to other places in the world. We provide technology that will enable scientists to work with bees, using the same technology, same experimental protocols, sharing the data, and hopefully then advance the knowledge about what's going on with the bees. And this really got a lot of attention from scientists from all over the world asking to join. Today we have hives instrumented in Kenya, in New Zealand, Mexico, in the Amazon. We do have here across Australia in many places. We collaborate with different universities in Australia, and we are expanding that to the United Emirates, to the whole Europe. As the winter is coming to an end, we're going to have a summer season with bees very active. And this is going to be a really global initiative.
From the minute to out-of-this-world projects, Paulo has been able to collaborate at the very cutting edge of science exploration. The tyranny of distance is no longer a limiting factor.
The broadband network we have at service in Tasmania also enable us to keep in touch with scientists around the world, with business around the world. It's really making a difference to what we do. So we can exchange large volumes of data, scientific data, data sets, data collections, images from Mars, in a very high pace. Video conference is something that works really well, so I'm still in touch and working really in a very daily basis, I would say, with our colleagues working with the NASA Mars Exploration Rover project. I just got a paper published yesterday about the latest discoveries on Mars, and this project is likely to continue for a couple of years. I hope it will.
With exciting science projects continuing to develop all over the world, is moving a consideration?
I could live anywhere I want. I'm a professional that I can work anywhere. But I decided to stay and to stick to Tasmania because this is a place that I was really welcome. It's a friendly environment and everybody really takes you as part of the community. I feel very much Tasmanian than probably Brazilian, because It is a great place where we have great neighbors, we have great communities, and we have great environment. It is a fantastic way of, life we have in Tasmania. And that helps me to become a better professional as well.